mouth confession is made, and with the heart man believeth unto righteousness. There is always something to do. If that glory is going to come, the glory will come. There will be salvation in Jesus' name. Healing is coming to you today. Who am I talking to there? Healing. Everybody shout healing. It will heal you. Tonight you are going to have a testimony. I said tonight you are going to have a testimony. But you must do something, because he says, this is the thing which the Lord has commanded that you should do. And then the glory that comes with the healing will come upon your life in Jesus' name. Number one, miracle, it's coming. Number two, salvation, it's coming. Number three, healing, it's coming. Number four, righteousness. Righteousness, you know, righteousness is so important. In fact, it says that except your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, ye shall in no wise see the kingdom of God. What does that mean? It means, you know, the Pharisees saying, this is how my heart is. I never hurt anybody. I'm all right. They have not been saved. I'm all right. I go to church, I pay tithes, I do this, I do that. That's not enough. That's not enough. The Lord is talking about in what righteousness? When the blood of Jesus comes to wash you and cleanse you, and then outside, inside, you're clean and righteous. In the church, outside the church, you're righteous. In the office, at home, you're righteous. And except you have that righteousness from the Lord, there's no way you get to the kingdom of God. But thank God, righteousness is available today. Jesus died for you. He wants to take your sin so that he can give you his righteousness. But you know, you will come to the Lord and say, Lord, I confess, I accept, I'm not righteous. You cannot be righteous by yourself. I come to Jesus Christ. I hold on to him. I believe in him. I want him to take my sin and give me his righteousness. It will happen. I said it will happen. You know that promotion comes because of the glory of God. When the glory of God comes upon your life, promotion will come. I said promotion will come. But you will turn away from every other sin that belongs to Satan. You know, you cannot say, Satan, give me this, and Jesus, give me this. If you have it, we don't know who has given you. Because there are people that go into occultism, I want to have this. There are people that go into charms, I want to have this. And we cannot tell who has given you. And the Lord is not going to share his glory with the devil. You leave the devil and you come to Christ, power will come in your life. Promotion will come in your life. Progress will come in your life. He said, in fact, it says, listen to this, it will show me grace and glory, and nothing good shall he ever withhold from them that walk uprightly. And if you will come to the Lord and say, I've been wobbling, I've not been living right, but now I want to stand firm, and stand in the word of the Lord, in the way of the Lord, and say, Lord, show me your glory. That glory will come tonight in Jesus' name. And then there'll be peace in your heart. Can I have an amen there? There'll be progress in your life. Another amen. There'll be prosperity in Jesus' name. Number one, the absence of God's glory. Number two, the appearance of God's glory. Number three, it's the abundance of God's glory. It's coming. You're almost there. I said it's coming. And the abundance of the glory of God will come in your life in Jesus' name. And look at this. Point number three, the manifestation. Everybody shout manifestation. The manifestation of the abundance of God's glory. The manifestation of the abundance of God's glory. Ezekiel chapter 43 verse 5. In verse 5 it says, so the Spirit took me up. The Spirit of the Lord will take you up. Take you out of the dungeon. Bring you on the mountaintop. The Spirit of the Lord took me up and brought me into the inner court. And behold, the glory of the Lord filled the house. Look around. The glory of the Lord filled the house. It's coming on you there. I said it's coming on you there. Look at that. It's coming over you there in Jesus' name. The manifestation of the abundance of God's glory. Manifestation of the abundance of God's glory. There are two verses that are linked together. I will read them to you. And then, as you see that, then you begin to understand, how does that manifestation come? How will I be a partaker of the manifestation of the glory of God tonight? I see a partaker over there. I said, I see a partaker over there. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. And the glory of the Lord with miracle. The glory of the Lord with forgiveness. The glory of the Lord with salvation. The glory of the Lord with righteousness. The glory of the Lord with promotion. And the glory of the Lord with every good blessing. The glory of the Lord with the peace of God will come upon your life tonight in Jesus' name. Glory. I said glory. I said glory. Look at this now in 2 Chronicles chapter 7. 2 Chronicles chapter 7. I read to you from verse 1. 2 Chronicles chapter 7. And I'm looking at verse 1 now when Solomon had made an end of praying. The fire came down from heaven. It's coming. I said it's coming. And consumed the burnt offering and the sacrifice. Listen to this. And the glory of the Lord filled the house. The glory of the Lord filled the house. Listen to what God said after that in verse 14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. Tonight is the night of answered prayer. I will forgive their sin. Tonight is the night of forgiveness. The night of freedom. And the night of salvation. I will forgive their sin. And I will heal their land. It's about to start. I said it's about to start. In verse 1, the glory of the Lord filled the house. Now, for each individual, for you over there, for you over there, for you over there, if the abundance of the glory is going to appear unto you, and you are going to be filled with the glory of the Lord, if my people which are called by my name, if they will humble themselves, if they will seek my face, if they will pray and turn from their wickedness, then the Lord says the glory will begin to manifest in forgiveness and healing. And tonight it is here. I said tonight it is here. Habakkuk chapter 2 is the verse I'm going to join with that. Habakkuk chapter 2, and I'm reading from verse 2. And the Lord answered me. The Lord will answer you today. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision. Write the vision. Make it plain upon the tables that he may run that readeth it. That he may run that readeth it. You know what the Lord is saying? He's saying the glory will not just come. There must be action. Action on your part. It is the cooperation between man and God. The interrelationship between the human and the supernatural and the divine. That's what will bring this glory upon your life. Look at verse 3. Then in verse 3 it says, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. Your appointed time has come. But at the end it shall speak and not lie, though it tarry. Yet it says, wait for it. Don't go home tonight, because before you go, something supernatural will happen. Because it will surely come. It will surely come. It will surely come. It will not tarry. It says in verse 4, behold, his soul which is lifted up is not upright in him, but the just shall live by faith. The just shall live by faith. Look at verse 14. If we combine 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14, I will combine that with Habakkuk chapter 2 verses 2 to 4. See the result in chapter 2 of Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 14. For the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Give me a good amen. Glory of the Lord to cover this place tonight, to drop upon your life today, and to come to you today. Let me summarize now what I read in Habakkuk and in 2 Chronicles. Number one, run. Number one, run. Because it says, write the vision. Make it plain. Make it clear. Show them the way of the Lord, how the glory will come. That the person that reads that, the person that hears that, and the person that knows that will run. That's a word of action. It's a word of moment, of movement. And the Lord is saying tonight, the glory is here. It's a time of repentance. And the person who was hurt, and the person who has known that, and the person who reads this, let him run. It's not just going to sit back there and say, glory come. It says, no, let him run. And you're coming to Christ tonight. Somebody there said you are coming to Christ tonight. You need to take a move. And you need to say, oh Lord, I come. Oh Lord, I come. As you are coming, the Lord will meet you on the way. Number two, humble yourself. That's what we're told in 2 Chronicles. Yes, you run. Yes, you come. Yes, you say, I want the Lord. But let him humble himself while you're seeking the Lord. Then he says, number three, pray and seek his face. Pray and seek his face. It's not just that, you know, I came to the crusade. I was at the stadium. Do something. If any change is going to happen in your life, you will open your mouth and say, Lord, I need you. Somebody needs the Lord tonight. I said, somebody there, you need the Lord tonight. And the Lord will appear to you in Jesus' name. Number one is to run. Number one is to take a step. Number one is to stay, is to say, I will not stay back in sin. I will not stay in evil. I drop that evil. I drop that transgression. I drop that occultism. I run away from that. I run away from sin. I run to the Savior. Number two is to humble yourself. Number three is to pray. You will pray tonight. I said you will pray tonight. And then you seek the face of the Lord. Number four is in 2 Chronicles. Let him turn from his wicked way. Let him turn from his wicked way. And you're saying, Lord, I didn't know that before. I didn't see that before. I didn't understand that before. But now I understand. Now I understand that I need to turn. I myself, I need to change. I myself, I need to say bye-bye to my evil. Lord, I turn unto you. And as you turn to the Lord tonight, he will accept you in Jesus' name. And then I come back to Habakkuk number five, number one, run. Number two, you humble yourself. Number three, you pray and you seek his face. Number four, you turn from your wicked way. Number five, have faith in God. Have faith in God. Because Habakkuk says, the just shall live by faith. Life is coming to you today. Eternal life is coming to you today. Abundant life is coming to you today. Have faith in God. He said, whosoever comes unto me, I will in no wise reject. It will not cast you away. Lord, I'm coming. Lord, I'm coming. And as you come, it will receive you in Jesus' name. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, that's your right, that's your name right there, whosoever believeth in him will not perish but have everlasting life. You'll have everlasting life. Are you there? Where are you? Everlasting life is coming in Jesus' name. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, number 6 is what God said he will do in 2 Chronicles. will forgive their sin. I will forgive their sin, no matter what you have done. If you will take that step, you come. If you take that step, you humble yourself. If you take that step, you pray. If you take that step, you turn from your evil way. If you take that step, you have faith in God. Tonight, He will forgive your sin. All the burden of sin will be taken away. All the load of sin will be taken away. All the condemnation of sin will be taken away. He will write your name in the book of life. You say, praise the Lord, I am forgiven. Praise the Lord, I am free. He will forgive you. And then number 7, He said, I will heal their land. He will heal you there. Blind eyes will open. The lame will rise up and walk. A miracle of healing, deliverance will come upon your life. It's coming. Where is it coming? I said, where is it coming? To whom is it coming? It's coming to you right there. I said, it's coming to you right there. Miracle. Miracle. Salvation. Miracle. Forgiveness. Miracle. Healing. Miracle. Deliverance. It is coming. It's coming. Are you ready? I said, are you ready? He told you what to do. So that the glory will come. The coming of the glory brings salvation. The coming of the glory brings miracle. The coming of the glory brings healing. The coming of the glory brings righteousness. And now, as we are going, I'm going to give you a challenge. I like challenges. I don't like, you know, the people that don't like to take any challenge. They just want to sit down there and say, okay, God, whatever will happen, let it happen. No. You will do something. And you are ready tonight. I said you are ready tonight. It's telling us in Isaiah chapter 60. Isaiah chapter 60. I'm reading to you from verse 1. Arise and shine. Arise and shine. You see there? Arise and shine. The person I'm talking to, I said, you see there? Arise and shine. For thy light has come. And the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. That glory is coming right now. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth. And then gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon you. I said the Lord shall arise upon you. And his glory shall be seen upon you. Your time has now come. It tells us in verse 18, violence shall no more be heard in thy land. Wasting, no destruction within thy borders. But thou shalt be called the world, thy world's salvation. And thy great praise, salvation is coming there. Yours is salvation tonight. The sun shall no more be the light during the day, neither for brightness shall the moon give thee light, give light unto thee, but the Lord shall be unto thee an everlasting light, and thy God, thy glory, the God who forgives, glory, the God who saves, glory, the God who heals, glory. And the God who delivers glory. Verse 20, thy sun shall no more go down. Neither shall the moon withdraw itself. For the Lord shall be thine everlasting light. And the days of thy mourning, the days of thy sorrow,